Hey friends, welcome back to Whiskey and Whit. I'm Whitney, and today's video is going to be a very requested, long-awaited Canva tips and tricks. I mention it in so many videos that I use it for cut files, printables, all that stuff. So we're gonna cover some of my favorite tips today to hopefully help you get designing in Canva so you can make your own. So like I said, this video is highly requested. Every time I mention that I use Canva to design stuff, I get a lot of questions, so I wanted to sit down, make a video, and run you through some of my favorite tips and tricks. Now, Canva is an amazing tool. It's a free online resource. However, there is so many things that you could do that this is not going to be all-encompassing. So if I get through this video and you think of something that you would like me to cover in a future video, please let me know in the comments down below. I'd be happy to cover that in a future video. So without further ado, let's get designing in Canva.
So step one, let's get you started with Canva. So you need to create an account. You can either log in with your Google account, your Facebook account, or you can do an email and password login. It is completely free for Canva. They do have paid options, but you can do what I'm going to show you in the free option. And the nice thing is everything is shared online and saved there in the cloud. You can also access it via their mobile app, which is really nice because I run out of space on my desktop on the regular. And it is really nice to not have to save all of this to an external drive. I can access it from anywhere, so it's super nice. So once you log in, this is the main home screen. Over here on the side, you can look up anything. So your designs, they have templates. As you get designing, things will be down here. So here are thumbnails that I've created for prior videos. So here you can select from some of the most common designs. So as you can see here, YouTube channel art, thumbnails, story highlight covers, presentations, they really have anything. So say you're looking to create an Instagram post, you can just come up here and type in Instagram. And it'll give you a lot of different options. So before we get into the printables and the cut files, I wanted to show you my top five favorite Canva things really quickly. So let's just say we're gonna make YouTube channel art. So my number one favorite thing is the remove background feature, and that's because it is so easy. So I'm gonna go over here to my photos, actually my uploads, and I'm going to select something that I've uploaded. So let's find an image. Here we are, super cute. So then what I'm going to do is go up here to effects and this background remover. So you can click it once and then it removes the background for you. So here's our cute little family all cut out. So then what I could do is put this like in the corner somewhere. If I'm making like a thumbnail or something, I could put this on a different background. So I could make this, move this to the background. You know, have this be like Whiskey and Whit, here's my family, blah, blah, blah. Here we are in the corner, put some text up here. It even cuts out my little curl there, which a lot of background cutters won't do. Now granted, over here in the corner, it looks like Alex doesn't have a hip, but for me, it's not a huge deal if I'm gonna use it as something like this. Number two is when I am looking for a specific look for text, but I'm not quite sure what the font name is. So say I add a headache and I'm gonna add Whiskey and Whit over here. I'm selecting this text and this is just the default text that it was when I added a header. So basically what I'm trying to do is I would like a script font. I want it to look like somebody did their handwriting, but I'm not quite sure what it's called and I don't really want to sift through 5 million things of fonts. No problem. So you're going to go up here to your fonts and you're going to type in calligraphy. You can type in a ton of different things, but for me, I'm looking for calligraphy. So here are all these handwritten calligraphy fonts. So I can go through and actually say, okay, that might be too thin. That one might be too thick. Okay, what am I looking for? I want something that's really that farmhouse handwriting situation. And this one's Caitlin and I like it. So we're gonna make this a little bit bigger. Here's the font. But that was a lot quicker than going through a ton of different options. I'm gonna go down here, select this color, and ta-da, I've got that font. Number three of my favorite things are these font combinations. So I usually have a pretty good luck figuring out what fonts I wanna put together just because I've done design before, but if you haven't, it's super hard to know like what goes together, what fonts you even like, etc. So over here, there are a ton of different options of fonts that Canva has already said, you know, these look good together visually. So you can scroll through, figure out what you like. So this one gives you a header. So you can go ahead and click on it. It will give you a couple different options. I can go in here and select this text, do whiskey and wit. You can select this, make it bigger. You can get rid of this. You can make it bigger down here. You can then play with it from there. I can make this bolder. If you want to design one piece on its own, you can just click on group. And so then it won't move around as a chunk anymore. You can go over here, decide that you want to make this font much bigger because it's not working as the small font, whatever you want to do. But it's a really nice starting point over here to get a collection of fonts. Another thing that I love on here that might seem super simple, but it's really nice, is the align feature. So say I'm gonna add a couple things. So now they're all over the place. What if I want these all to be aligned? It's super easy. So you can go ahead and select all of them here and go up here to position. Then you can do a lot of different options. So I can say align all of these with the left. So they'll all align left here. You can do the same thing on the right side. You can also do center, which is awesome because then all these things are centered. Or we can then go in and evenly vertically displace them or horizontally displace them. Or you can align them all with the bottom. You know, if you've got things going vertically, you could do the same thing with the top. So there are a lot of different ways here that you can align stuff. It's really hard to do it manually. So this is nice. You know that they're all aligned. Just click it and be done. And then my last favorite feature for my top five are these templates. So if you're going through and deciding that you want to make an Instagram story, for example, we're going to go up here and say create new design. We're going to type in Instagram story. Okay, great. We're going to open up a new window. Maybe it's 4th of July. So then you can go over here and click a template. And this is a fill in the blank 4th of July edition. So then I can go in here and say, okay, this font isn't actually what I want. So I'm going to change this. I'm going to change it to this guy. I'm going to go in here. This blue is not the blue that I want. So I'm going to pick a different blue, etc. But those templates are a really great starting point so that you can create something without having to look at a blank screen. Let's say that I've got an 8x10 frame. So I'm actually going to go up here to create a design, click on that. And I'm gonna do custom dimensions. So I want mine to be portrait. So my width is gonna be 8x10, and I'm gonna wanna change this to inches. PX means pixels, millimeters, centimeters, etc. The pixels are really only if you're designing for digital, that you're gonna wanna really pay attention to that, but I usually design in inches. So I'll go ahead and change this over here, 8 to 10. So you click create design. And we are headed into a page. So like I said, this is the blank page you could stare at, or you can use this template. So whatever size you put in, they'll give you some ideas over here. So typically when I go to design, I look for a saying. So I will head over to Pinterest. So let's just say I want to create something for my kitchen, printable, or maybe even sign. Let's do that. So here are a lot of different examples for signs, printables, and this is usually where my creative juices get going, so that I can kind of figure out what I want to put on the sign. So I'm going to go with this image. So over here is where you can add pretty much anything you want. So let's start with the text. So let's click on this one. Once you click on it, it will put it on the page for you. And this is a grouped situation. So you can edit this, a gift, and you can also edit just for you. So let's start typing. So that saying was, and so together they built. And typically when I'm creating text, I want to look at how one is going to work with the other. So really what looks good, and then also within the actual text, what words do you want to stand out? So in this saying, and so together they built a life that they loved. A life that they loved seems to be kind of the focus of the quote. I'm going to duplicate this here. So that's this button up here. And so then I'm going to say, and so together they built a, this one, I'm just clicking on this and editing, so a life. And then here I'm going to do that, they, and then loved. So then when I'm editing here, you can drag this big or small to figure out your sizing. You can also edit your text up here. It's very similar to how you would edit in Word. And then what you can do is ungroup this. And basically what the group ungroup does is it allows you to freely move this. So I'm going to make this a little bit bigger here. And then also now I'm starting to basically work as a game of kind of Tetris. So I want this all to fit together. So I'm thinking, and so together they built. And then here I'm creating a spot so that I can put this big life here. We're gonna ungroup the same section over here and take this piece. I'm just dragging this dot in the corner to make it a little bigger. So then I'm looking to kind of make it work around these jut outs from the L and the F. So here I'm trying to put this here. I can make it a little smaller so that it'll fit there. And then loved, I want the same thing. I want it to be nice and big. And now that I look at both of these, I kind of want to scooch this over to play off of the F. So then I'm going to add a little space here for the A. So then the L fits kind of right in there, built a life. That they, and then life, we can make it a little bit smaller here. Fit that in there, fit that with the F there. You could honestly move this in here so that that all intertwines. Or I think what I'm gonna do is have the L be there so it kind of fits in that spot. Make this a little bit smaller and put that in the hole. So basically, the way that the topography looks when it's all together, I like it when it kind of fits together there so it looks like it was always meant to be together. I like how this all looks together, kind of flows. So then I'm going to go over here and find an element. Now, if you were going to cut this out via Cricut, then what you would do is you could just export it now. So what you would do is you would go up here to this publish and you can do a lot of different things. You can share it, you can download it, etc. So if you're going to download it, you can click download. Now these options here are because I have premium, so the transparent background, but I'm gonna show you how on the free version you can get this ready to be cut out for your Cricut. So you're gonna export as a PNG and you're gonna go ahead and click download. I'm gonna show you how you can kind of snazz this up a little bit so it can be a printable. So what I would do is I would come over here and I would look in the kind of the different elements, which is gonna be under this tab here. So I like to add laurels a lot. If you're going through here and you're seeing that some items are showing up as pro and you don't want to pay for them, all you have to do is click this little filter up here. You can pick certain colors, whatever. You can also click this box and it will apply so everything that's free will show up. So let's say I like this one. I'm gonna make it green. I'm gonna make this a little bit bigger so it fits the whole page. And then say I want this text to actually fit within this. So I'm gonna go ahead and select the text. So I'm gonna select one. I'm gonna hold down my shift key and click the rest of these elements. Get this out of the way so I don't select it. So you can either hit shift and select all of them, or you can take your mouse and just kind of glide over there to select all of them like I just did. So we're gonna make this, while it's designed, a little bit smaller. So then that way it can fit within the laurel here. I'm gonna drag this a little bit bigger. Now what you can also do is you can take this item and go up to position. This is where you're able to align things, or you can send this to the back. So then that way this little dot down here is going to come out front. Basically what I'm going to do is go through and select these, but then hit the shift key and unselect the outside. Then you can start messing with this, moving it around so it fits within this like laurel situation here. So then what you could also do is you could go over to photos and you could find a kind of wooden background. So here's, you can really type in whatever you're looking for here. Same thing with the filter, but I'm going to go ahead and select this. You may have seen this on my channel. I like to use this image, but I'm more concerned about this right hand side so that it doesn't take away with those flowers. So here's this shiplap look. So I'm going to take this, make sure it's big enough. Go to position, send it all the way to the back. And then right now it's kind of hard to see. So what I'm gonna do is click this image and I'm gonna go up here to this transparency. It kind of looks like a checkerboard and I'm gonna pull this down. So basically it's gonna make it a little bit more see-through. I'm gonna take it down to 30. So now you can actually see what you've got here. You can change the colors of the text, but then you also have kind of this watermarked wood in the background, which is awesome for your printable because you can put this in a frame and it's gonna look very put together, like you printed it from, you know, a Etsy page or something like that. If you're looking for wood, you can come up here and do like rustic or wood. click that, and there's a ton of different options over here. So if I wanted to do this, I could drag it over and actually like fill it in behind. So if I wanted this lighter wood, once I get it in there, if I decide that white is not, you know, showing up enough, I can crank up that transparency. I could go in here, I could say, okay, I actually don't want green, I want it to be more, you know, this color. Okay, great. Then I can go and select this text. Again, say black is actually too harsh. So then you can just go up here to the color, do a lighter color, do a darker color, and then ta-da! You have a printable that looks like you got it from, you know, Etsy, Pinterest, but you designed it yourself. Doing the free version of Canva, you cannot export with a transparent background. However, what you can do is you can go to Google, type in remove background, remove.bg. I will link this down below for you. What you're going to want to do is upload your image from the desktop. So I'm going to go over here and find this one. It's going to upload, and because you have black text on a white background, it's going to cut it out for you here. Click download. So now once you're over in design space, you can go ahead and create a new project. And you're going to go to upload over here. You're going to upload it. I usually just select simple, and then it's going to show up in here as a cut file, insert images. And there it is, to make larger, smaller, you know, kind of whatever you're looking for to create. Now, sometimes with certain fonts, you won't get as clean of lines here. You can also come in to go to upload. We're going to upload our one with the background. So this is the white background file. And then what you can do here is go up and do the select and erase, which looks like a magic wand. Click it. It's going to do your background. Then you can go in here and select these. Now, if you've got a ton of text, this is going to be a pain in the butt. There's not a ton of text, so I can go in and cut this out. So here, it's a pretty quick process. Put it in Cricut, insert. And this one, as you can see, your letters are a little bit better as far as looking like what you exported out of Canva.
Thank you so much for watching. I really hope these tips and tricks help you design your own printables, cut files, social media graphics, really whatever you want to design in Canva, the sky's the limit. Let me know in the comments down below what your favorite tip was, how you're going to use this, and also, like I mentioned before, if there's something that I didn't have a chance to cover today, let me know and we will do a round two if you guys would like to see that. So again, thanks so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!